So here we are. We survived day zero.
And negative one.
And negative one. Going on to day zero.
That's all I gotta say.
Yeah, going on to day one. We got Josh here. Woo! Here we are at camp, about to head back in. Woo! This guy's showing some beautiful pictures over here.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, man.
See you at church, my friend. You too can be saved.
Have fun, happy lost land.
You too. You all can be saved. Just remember to go to church tonight.
All right. So, the only thing I'm going to tell you is fucking church. Fucking church.
Fucking church. Woo.
Good. So eventually when we did get in, we started with Jansen.
Oh, this is a brand new song I just finished last night with my boy Taboo. You guys are the first to hear it.
Next, we went to Kaiwachi, who actually wasn't scheduled to be there this year. We saw him in 2018, so it was kind of cool to see him again at the Wampy Woods.
Oh shit.
that, we went into Company.
Hell yeah.
And then one of our most anticipated sets of the whole weekend we were really looking forward to was Maruda.
There's not very much variation in the sound design.
No.
But it's still really good, because if you like the sound, of course you're going to enjoy it.
Decided to go over to the Paradox, and we caught the end of Ghastly.
Uncle Rob's most beloved artist. The reason why he goes to these shows at all. BTSM. Black Tiger Sex Machine.
Oh my god, second year in a row, BTSM just fucking blew our minds.
Yeah.
Great set. Their music just draws you in, and they definitely know how to put on a show.
And they definitely had some higher tempo songs in this set, which I really appreciated.
BTSM was my favorite, of course. Zed's Dead, baby! I really wanted Zed's Dead at Lost Lands in 2018, convinced they were going to be the secret special guest, which they weren't. So to catch Zed's Dead after BTSM, I honestly could not have asked for a better night.
Thank you. Sit, yeah, for sure. If not the whole thing, but you gotta be there to see the new intro.
Wanted to check out Rusko, so we ran over to the Wampy Woods and ended our night on a great note. Yeah, Rusko, he did it again. One of the biggest improvements was more space. This year the sound camps were held actually inside of Legend Valley grounds. So they had extended some of the areas out to allow the sound camps after the sets ended at the end of the night.
We didn't check out a lot of the sound camp people. One thing is that it's late, another thing is that it's more quiet for the sound restrictions that they have. But you know, we gotta go see our boy Chime.
Yeah.
Cause man, he's a great producer, murderer with the sound. I love him. I love it.
For a little bit, like I said, the sound camps were quieter than a lot of us would have liked, so we decided to head back to camp, which we were grateful we did, because Friday night brought some rain and some lightning, and
our headbangers were spoiled. Excision spoiled all of us. We're like, it's so quiet. It's not 500,000 watts. Anyway, guys, follow Magic the Frenchie on Instagram.
Magic _ the Frenchie.
There you go. Use promo code magic for
nothing.